spilling the tea.
This is the Rumor Report with Angela Yee on The Breakfast Club.
Well, Beyonce is on the cover of Vogue magazine, and she talks about a lot of things. She talks about her body, and after the birth of her first child, she said, "I believed in the things society said about how my body should look. I put pressure on myself to lose all the baby weight in 3 months and scheduled a small tour to assure I would do it. Looking back, that was crazy. I was still breastfeeding when I performed the Revel shows in Atlantic City in 2012. After the twins, I approached things very differently." She talks about being 218 pounds the day that she gave birth to the twins. She said, "To this day, my arms, shoulders, breasts, and thighs are fuller. I have a little mommy pooch, and I'm in no rush to get rid of it. I think it's real. Whenever I'm ready to get a six-pack, I will go into beast zone and work my ass off until I have it. But right now, my little fupa, and I feel like we are meant to be."
I read that article. Great article, by the way. And let the record show, I love baby weight. Envy, you know. Your wife been pregnant 20 times.
Five times.
My wife is pregnant now.
Men get a little baby weight, too.
There's nothing more beautiful than an eight-month pregnant woman after they've gained about 20-30 pounds.
All right, she also talks about her ancestry. She says, "I come from a lineage of broken male-female relationships, abuse of power, and mistrust. Only when I saw that clearly was I able to resolve those conflicts in my own relationship. Connecting to the past and knowing our history makes us both bruised and beautiful." She said that she learned she came from a slave owner who fell in love with and married a slave in her ancestry. "I had to process that revelation over time. I questioned what it meant and tried to put it into perspective." She says she believes that's why God blessed her with her twins also.
Well, what ancestry test is Beyonce taking that she got them fine details? Mm. All I know is the region I'm from and the country and the tribe.
Well, I'm sure
you ain't got Beyonce.
Had something more extensive.
That I know. You don't have to remind me. Don't tell me obvious stuff. Anything else obvious you want to tell me today?
Nope. All right. She talks about the On the Run tour and the On the Run 2 tour. She said the Berlin show was one of the most memorable moments, the site of the 1936 Olympics. She said this is the site that was used to promote the rhetoric of hate, racism, and divisiveness. And it's the place where Jesse Owens won 4 gold medals, destroying the myth of white supremacy. Less than 90 years later, 2 black people performed there to a packed, sold-out stadium. So read the whole article if you want to get some more. She talks about having a son and how she wants him to be strong and brave, but he can also be sensitive and kind.
And vulnerable, yeah.
And to have a high emotional IQ and to be caring, truthful, and honest. It's everything a woman wants in a man, and yet we don't teach it to our boys.
High emotional IQ is very important. It's a great book that you can read called actually Emotional IQ. Mm. I read that before.
Makes sense. All right, Demi Lovato is out of the hospital and getting treatment at a rehab facility. She's going to stay there for an extended period of time. So we'll keep you guys up to date on her progress as after she overdosed. Now, they said there's no time frame for her rehab, but it'll be for an extended period, which is at least 30 days. LeBron is producing a docuseries, Shut Up and Dribble, that's going to be for Showtime. It's a 3-part documentary series, and it's about the changing role of athletes in the current political environment. Now, that's going to be going down, just basically talking about things like the Golden State Warriors declining an invitation to the White House after the finals and things like that. So
I love seeing people take a so-called negative and flipping it into a positive. I know that lady got to feel stupid as hell now that he done turned it into a whole docuseries, Shut Up and Dribble, or Shut Up and Buy a School, either one.
Now, LeBron James's I Promise School, they're giving us some more information on Bleacher Report about the financials of it. So apparently that school is going to cost about $8 million per year for taxpayers. And for LeBron James Family Foundation, they're going to be planning to spend at least $2 million annually when the school has grown to capacity to make sure that everything they want to get accomplished happens. It's for at-risk students. And we've been telling you about the school that opened last week with free uniforms, free breakfast, lunch, and snacks, free transportation within 2 miles, free bicycles and helmets, access to a food pantry for the families, all kinds of job training, and so on and so forth. But it is for taxpayers to take care of because it is a public school that people have access to. Mm-hmm. And Jennifer Lopez is going to be starring in a movie. It's called Hustlers at Score. She signed on to star in that. And it's based on a true story. It's former strip club employees who turned the tables on their Wall Street clientele by creating a scheme that allows them to steal tens of thousands of dollars from their wealthy clients. Sounds good to me. She's going to play the former stripper and the ringleader of the group of women who are planning to rob these men. All right, I'm Angela Yee, and that is your Rumor Report.